So good morning everyone. So today we are going to discuss about quantum free electron theory. So according to quantum free electron theory, so various drawbacks of classical free electron theory were answered. So classical free electron theory failed to explain the different properties of materials such as superconducting properties, magnetic properties like paramagnetic properties and ferromagnetic properties, and it failed to derive the correct expression for thermal conductivity. So all those drawbacks were eliminated with the help of quantum free electron theory. So this theory was proposed by Sommerfeld in 1928. So by making only few changes in the classical free electron theory and by retaining most of the postulates of classical free electron theory. So Sommerfeld assumed that the electrons present in the lost orbits, so which are nothing but free electrons or valence electrons, are responsible for conduction of electricity. And here, according to quantum free electron theory, so the free electrons in a metal can have only discrete energy values. That means the energy values are quantized. So like classical free electron theory, where the energy is continuous, here the energy is only discrete value. It has definite fixed value which cannot be altered. So the energy value of electron is generally given by the expression E equal to n square h square by 8m. Is the positive integer and h is the Planck's constant, and m is the mass of the electron and a is the length of the box in which the electrons is trapped. The electrons have the same potential energy everywhere within the metal. They cannot come out from the metal surface due to very high potential barrier, so hence they are trapped inside a potential well. So here he suggested that, so since free electrons are free to move everywhere inside the metal surface, but they could not come out of the metal surface. That means it is assumed like, so a particle is trapped and is bounded inside certain well, so which is known as potential well. So quantum free electron theory carried out the same principle. So here also free electrons will have same potential energy everywhere within the metal. So they will not come out of the metal surface due to very high potential barrier offered by the lattice arrangements. So here the electrons obey Pauli's exclusion principle, so which states that they cannot be more than two electrons in any energy level. So Pauli's exclusion principle, so only two electrons are present in any energy level, so with opposite spins. That means if one electron has positive spin, which is known as spin up, the other electron will have a negative value of the spin, so which is known as spin down. So only two electrons will accommodate in any energy level. So according to quantum free electron theory, so distribution of electrons in various energy levels obey the Fermi-Dirac quantum statistics. So here, according to the Fermi-Dirac quantum statistics, so we can find the distribution of electrons in various energy levels. So it gives the probability of finding electron in particular energy level at certain temperature. So here the force of attraction between electrons and lattice ions and the force of propulsion between electrons can be neglected. So we know that there exists force of attraction between positive charge and negative charge. That means electrons will attract towards the positive charge, which are nothing but the protons. And similarly, two electrons, so which has the same charge, will get repelled. So here inside the crystal, so these two forces are neglected in case of quantum free electron theory. And there is loss of energy due to interaction of free electrons with the other free electrons. So here the collisions with one particle to another particle is assumed to be inelastic. That means there is loss of energy when one electron collides with the another free electron, or else if it collides with the another lattice ions present inside the metal. So here, according to quantum free electron theory, so we have understood that the free electrons so will distribute in various levels according to Fermi-Dirac functions. So we should know what is this Fermi-Dirac distribution. So according to Fermi-Dirac distribution, so we should know various concepts related to Fermi-Dirac distribution, such as Fermi level, Fermi energy, and Fermi factor. So which tell the probability of occupation of given energy level by different electrons. So here, if you look at this diagram, so this is the concept of Fermi-Dirac distribution. So this is the graph which shows us electrons in various energy levels with respect to Fermi energy. So here, if you look at this, in each and every energy level, there are only two electrons present in each energy level. So here, the electrons will occupy first the lower energy levels and then next energy levels and so on. So here, every electron has certain spin, so which is paired with the another electron with opposite spin. So such kind of two electrons only present inside the Fermi-Dirac energy levels. So related to Fermi-Dirac distribution, so we should know what is the Fermi level. So Fermi level is nothing but the highest reference level of a particle at absolute zero temperature. So according to this Fermi-Dirac distributions, we have assumed that so each and every electron will occupy first the lowest energy level and after that next highest energy level. So according to this, so we will have the highest energy level, so which is occupied by the last electrons. So that level is nothing but the Fermi level. So at absolute zero temperature, so the highest reference level of a particle is generally considered as Fermi level. So this is the reference energy level which separates the filled energy levels and vacant levels. So generally, below the Fermi energy level, so all the energy levels are completely filled by the electrons. So whereas above the Fermi energy level, so all the energy levels are empty. So that is why the main importance of Fermi energy level is, so it separates all the filled electron energy levels from the vacant energy levels. Coming to the Fermi energy, Fermi energy is the maximum energy of a quantum state corresponding to Fermi energy level at absolute temperature. So Fermi level is nothing but the highest energy level of a particle. So where the particles occupy certain energy level at last. So the energy associated with that Fermi level is nothing but the Fermi energy. So Fermi energy determines the energy of the particle at any temperature. So not only at absolute temperature, at any temperature, the occupation of that particular Fermi level is defined by the Fermi energy. So coming to the Fermi factor, so this gives the probability of occupation of a given energy level under thermal equilibrium. So whenever the temperature is assumed constant, that means when there is no net flow from the material or to the material, so then it is assumed to be a thermal equilibrium. So in thermal equilibrium, so the chance of occupying particular energy level, so is generally given by the Fermi factor. So the expression for Fermi factor is f of E equal to 1 by 1 plus exponential E minus EF by KV into T. So here E is the energy of particular particle and EF is the Fermi energy. So whereas KB is the Boltzmann constant and T is the absolute temperature. So now we are going to see how this Fermi factor will vary with respect to energy and temperature. So we are going to consider different cases. So for studying Fermi Dirac distributions, so which shows the occupation of electrons. So case one, we are going to find out Fermi factor. So when energy of electron is less than Fermi energy and the temperature is at 0 Kelvin. So whenever E is less than EF and T value is 0 Kelvin, so from the probability function F of E we have, we know that 1 by 1 plus exponential E minus F by KB into T. See, whenever E is less than F, so here we are going to get the minus value. So, and here T is assumed to be 0. So, minus something value by, so 0. So, that means, so we are going to get minus infinity. So, minus some existed value by 0 is nothing but, 1 by 0 is nothing but infinity. So here we are going to get minus, that is why 1 by e power minus infinity plus 1. So e power minus infinity value is nothing but 0. So 1 by 1 plus 1, 1 plus 0. So which is nothing but the value 1. So whenever e is very less than f and t value is 0, so Fermi factor we are going to get as 1. So which tells us at 0 absolute temperature, so all the energy levels below Fermi energy are 100% occupied by electrons. That means, so at absolute temperature 0 Kelvin, so when the Fermi energy is greater than the energy of electron, so all the electrons so will occupy so the levels below the Fermi level. Fermi factor when the energy of electron is greater than Fermi energy and absolute temperature is 0 Kelvin. So in this case we are going to get the positive value in the numerator. So since E value is 0, so 1 by 0 is infinity. So we are going to get now E power infinity plus 1. So E power infinity is nothing but infinity. So 1 by infinity plus 1 is nothing but the 1 by infinity. So 1 by infinity value is 0. So Fermi factor we are going to get is 0. That means the energy of electron is greater than Fermi energy. Then the absolute temperature, so all the energy levels that are above the EF are completely vacant. That means they are unoccupied by the electrons. We are going to assume the energy of electron is same to that of Fermi energy and temperature is assumed as 0 Kelvin. So in such case, so we are going to get the form of a Fermi factor like this. F of E equal to, so 1 by E power, since E equal to E, here we are going to obtain the value 0. And temperature is 0, so E power 0 by 0 plus 1. So 0 by 0 is nothing but indeterminate state. So F of E we are going to get is indeterminate. That means we cannot determine what is the exact value of Fermi factor when E equal to EF and T equal to 0 Kelvin. So F of E equal to infinity. So for E equal to EF at T equal to 0 Kelvin. So here the occupation of Fermi level at T equal to 0 Kelvin has undetermined value. So which can be ranged from 0 and 1. That means here the Fermi Dirac distribution function is discontinuous and its value will vary from 0 to 1. So whenever E equal to F and T equal to 0. Another case is when E equal to F but T is slightly greater than 0 Kelvin. So when E equal to F and T value is slightly greater than 0 Kelvin, so then F of E will become, since we have E equal to F in the numerator, we are going to get 0. Since T is assumed slightly greater than 0, so this value will not going to be. That is why, so we are going to get the Fermi factor value as F of E equal to 1 by E power 0 plus 1. So anything power 0 is 1. So 1 by 1 plus 1, that is equal to 1 by 2. So in case of energy of electron equal to Fermi energy, and T is slightly greater than 0, so then we are going to get the Fermi energy value as half. So which indicates that whenever the energy of electron is less than EF, so the problem is and then it will reach to 0.5. So whenever E equal to EF and the temperature is slightly greater. So and for E is very greater than EF, so finally it will become 0. So the distribution function can be shown like this. So here we are going to draw the graph between the energy of electron and Fermi factor. So if you check this, so if you observe this, so here we are going to see from the graph like, so whenever energy of electron is less than Fermi energy, so the occupation of electrons is more. That means the electrons are going to occupy the lower levels. So at 100%, that is why the value is at 1. And it will slowly decrease. And whenever the energy of electron is equal to the Fermi energy, so it is going to be equal to the half. And then, since whenever E equal to EF and T equal to 0, so the value is indeterminate. So it the function, the Fermi Dirac function will become discontinuous, and its value is will vary from 0 to 1. And after that, whenever energy of electron is greater than Fermi energy, so it will further decrease and finally it becomes 0. So the energy that is greater than Fermi energy. So this is how the variation of Fermi factor with respect to energy and temperature can be defined. So coming to the advantages of quantum free electron theory, so this theory is able to explain the drawbacks of classical free electron theory, that is nothing but it is able to explain the specific heat capacity of the materials. And this theory is able to explain the photoelectric effect, Compton effect, and block body radiation. So, which are the drawbacks of classical free electron theory? And this theory gives the correct mathematical expression for thermal conductivity of metals. Since classical free electron theory failed to explain the concept of thermal conductivity, so whenever temperature increases, how the conductivity of metals is going to be changed, this is not explained by the classical free electron theory. So, but the quantum free electron theory is able to explain the thermal relationships to the conductivity. But coming to the quantum free electron theory, so this theory fails to distinguish between metal, semiconductor, and insulator. So here also it failed to explain the properties of semiconductors and insulators. So quantum free electron theory is also limited to the properties of metals only. So it failed to distinguish between metals, semiconductors, and insulators. So that is why we require one more theory, which is known as zone theory or block theory. So it also fails to explain the positive value of Hall coefficient. So Hall coefficient tells us whenever current carrying conductor is placed inside the magnetic field, so voltage difference is going to be generated, which is perpendicular to the both current as well as the magnetic field. So, but here the quantum free electron theory failed to represent the positive value of Hall coefficient. So it will explain only the negative value of Hall coefficient, but failed to give the relationship for positive value of Hall coefficient. And according to this theory, only two electrons are present in the Fermi energy level, and only those are responsible for conduction, which is not true. See here, in order to increase conductivity, so we require more number of electrons to be present in various energy levels. But according to quantum free electron theory, only two electrons should be present. So because it's follows the Pauli's mutual exclusion principle. So this is not true in case of different materials. So all these are the drawbacks of quantum free electron theory.